Muchas gracias por la invitación.
Thank you very much for the invitation. I am a geneticist and I work in the National Center of Medical Genetics, where we have an epidemiology area where we deal with this registry. This depends from the Ministry of Health, our National Ministry of Health. As the previous presentations, this has tons of numbers, and this is one of the reasons why we created the National Registry on Congenital Anomalies. And it is because of the last 30 years, mortality at birth has decreased. In 1980, this was 30 over 1,000, and now it's 11 over 1,000. And as this decrease, we have been controlling certain infections and nutritional deficiencies, and the congenital anomalies became more relevant. The congenital anomalies, as you see, are stable, but started to be a more important part of this blue bar. In 1980, they represented 11%, but last year they represented 23%. So congenital anomalies starting being very important in child mortality, and there was no way of measuring the occurrence of the congenital anomalies. We knew how many of them died because of the anomalies, but we didn't know how many of them were born with the anomaly, in some cases of spina bifida, for example, but we have to measure them and have some information. So we created this tool with this aim in order to know about the burden of disease, and this shows how these congenital anomalies are the second cause of child mortality in Argentina. And amongst the aims of the RINAC, the first of them is the vigilance and the epidemiological research with the monitoring of the prevalence and the trend changes, as Liliana mentioned. For example, if you do fortification with folic acid, know whether this modifies the prevalence or not, to make research over certain areas in Argentina where they have a higher prevalence, to assess the impact of population interventions. But there is another general objective which is really important, which is to improve the attention and the care. This registry, which is epidemiological, it's not another report, another annual report that is kept in the ministry, but it must improve the initial management and the referral to the corresponding departments. You see how the registry evolved. It started in November 2009 with only 4 hospitals, and then expanded to the public sector, and for December 2012 we had almost 118 hospitals, and we kept on adding more and more public hospitals, and now we have from the private sector 140 hospitals. These are the same numbers that Liliana showed during this period. In this period we had 400 births, and this is how this system works. It works where babies are born. Neonatologists have a manual where they tell us what anomalies they should report. It has a yellow form that must be filled in with all the data, and by the end of the month, or by the beginning of the following month, online they send us the Excel, the information in the Excel format. This is important because here is where we have the greatest interaction with neonatologists. So on the coordination, we receive all the data, we code them, we analyze them, and then we give the information back, we give a feedback to the neonatologist in a large meeting in the city of Buenos Aires, and this information goes to the authorities or to those who need this information for some purpose. So I am going to center in this second part, which is the interaction in the forum, because it has to do with attention, with medical attention. This forum have, or the websites have set topics and messages. Forum defines the topic we're going to talk about. For example, here we discuss clinical cases. So what happens here? A neonatologist from Santa Fe here created a topic where he talks about a real case and he needs advice for the diagnosis. He talks here about a probable skeletal dysplasia, which is a congenital anomaly, and he uploads the medical chart as well as the x-rays and other studies or the complementary study. This is seen by us and by other geneticists. And this is very useful because it has to do with the teaching of a specific case. Different ways of using this. Each hospital has a private forum where we send the reports in an Excel form with the profile. And here is Pablo Barbero. Then he answers, everything is okay, or there's some information missing. Please fill in this other information. This is another example where we receive the information. This is a private forum where they send as a case, and according to the congenital anomaly, we suspect a specific genetic disease, and by the RENAC, we do the triangulation. This is a neonatologist from Tucumán, a province in the northern part of Buenos Aires. They send us the information from this hospital in Tucumán, and we connect this with the genetics lab in the Clínicas Hospital here in Buenos Aires City, which is a very specific study. They do the diagnosis, and we then put in connection this neonatologist with the Department of Genetics of the Children's Hospital in Tucumán. They were in the same province, but they were not used to working together. So this family can then have the advice and the diagnosis. The diagnosis was confirmed with a molecular study in this case. This is another example that has to do with sharing material. You have here Maria Paz Bidondo, another person who's in charge of the coordination. And she is sending this recommendations guidelines for those people affected with MMC. This was very practical. When a child is born with the affection, we answer giving them the guidelines so that they can have it in digital format. This is a case that I showed you before. We discussed a clinical case that was discussed with the network of neonatologists and geneticists. This is the fifth use, which has social interaction, which is the most important part, or one of the most important part, because if we want to generate changes, we must do this through networks of interacting people. And we stimulate this, we like creating this network, and on the annual meeting of the RENAC, we give awards. And the neonatologists think that this is really important because we give awards according to how the neonatologists work throughout the year, about the information they send, the best photos, the best pictures, the best x-rays, because in some anomalies we can do the diagnosis with the photos, the presentations of clinical cases for discussion, and so on and so forth. And we started this as a test, like as a trial. And as years go by, the neonatologists wonder, didn't I want my RENAC prize this year? I'm waiting for my prize. So in 2003, we started an online course, and we created an online course one about public health and genetics, etiology and prevention of congenital anomalies, this morphology and clinical management and epidemiology. And this online course has a part where the neonatologist or the physician must attend the course. And what we did here, we put together the neonatologists in different groups, and we handed out a clinical case, and then they had to do a role playing, a communication work, where they had to explain the deputies or the Ministry of Health or the media the importance of the congenital anomalies and why should they be sponsored by the ministry. And this is important because these people then get trained. From Buenos Aires, we can do nothing in the other provinces, but they are locals there and they can have an influence on the local level so that they can obtain more resources for the congenital anomalies program. These were residents here with a role playing, and it was really interesting, this experience. So, we think the information with this model, we go from data to action, and the information that we receive is transformed. For example, a data might be the report of a lumbosacrum open meningocele, but this is only data, and we must add then more data in order to generate information. For example, know that the prevalence of spina bifida is 0.58 over 1,000 live births. And the knowledge must be that the prevalence of spina bifida is similar in the different areas of the country or similar to other countries. Then we have to communicate this information. It's important if it reaches the community or the different organisms or the ministries or the people interested in knowing the number of cases per province, for example, of mielomeningocele, and this might serve in order to plan the attention or the healthcare services based on the number of estimated cases per area. Talking about spina bifida, this is a slide that Liliana showed before. In this period from 3 years, we examined more than 400,000 births. 240 had a spina bifida with a prevalence of 0.58 per 1,000 live birth. As we do not have an inclusive coverage, but we have a coverage in the public sector, and we are starting to work with the private sector, what we do is we extrapolate the number, and we assume that we will be having 450 new cases per year in Argentina. And this is the same applied per regions. If we think about region politics and how we send the resources according to the demand, it's important to know how many cases are estimated per region. This is going to be published where we're going to include spina bifida and other congenital anomalies. We also do other special activities as from the cases sent by the neonatologists. We work with them together in order to publish them in scientific magazines. We make research about the association of congenital anomalies and environmental factors. We study about how lethal some selected congenital anomalies might be, and we do this by means of a follow-up. We developed an atlas of congenital anomalies that is going to go to be printed this year and will be a guide for neonatologists in order to recognize the different entities. And we also, as Liliana mentioned, we distribute educational material for fathers of affected newborns because they are the first approach. Because the neonatologist is the one that hand these booklets out because they are the first encounter of the parents with the physicians. And this is how to stimulate the system. And we must be very motivated in order to recollect the information, and this might be stimulated by legal requirements, education, participation in projects, and putting clinical and therapeutic information to those that require it. And thank you very much for your attention. This is a photo of the National Academy of Medicine 2 years ago, and this is part of the neonatologists that participate, neonatologist group that participate in the RENAC. Thank you very much.